big and bad but can't find it? And the answer, werewolf. By the way, Boris Karloff. Do you know what his real name was?
Boris Dracula.
Does anybody know his real name?
No, what?
Bill Pratt.
No.
Not kidding.
Oh.
But they had to change it, you know.
Yeah, you did.
The
really
werewolf from the Blue Lagoon starring Bill Pratt. Never going to work with him. But that really was his name. Okay, let's get back to the game. Very tight, just a 4-point lead for Grant. Gayle, put some letters up there, please.
A consonant, please.
J.
And another?
N.
And another?
H.
And a vowel, please.
E.
And another?
E.
And another?
I.
Consonant?
X.
Consonant?
Sob in a corner for you, I think. L.
And another consonant,
and
please.
And another consonant. Thank you, Gayle. N.
And here's the clock. Gayle, what'd you get that time?
Just a 5.
Just the 5. Grant?
Just 5.
Just 5. Grant, what's your 5?
Exile.
Exile. Gayle's got exile.
Indeed she
not,
has.
Not many other words you could work out here. Have you got a 6?
No.
No.
I've got a 5. Helix.
Helix.
Three-dimensional object, yeah.
Excellent. Well, excellent considering what you've got to play with there. So just a 4 points difference remains the score. And Grant, this time, we'll be seeing if we can stretch that lead. Off you go.
Consonant, please, Carol.
S.
Another.
R.
And another.
T.
Vowel, please.
E.
Another.
A.
Consonant.
K.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
R.
consonant.
That's very good. And P.
Right, here's the clock. Be surprised if the number 8 rears its head. What have you got, Gayle?
Yeah, an 8.
You got an 8 and Grant?
An 8, yes.
What's yours?
Streaker?
No.
Yeah.
And what have you got? Streaker? No. There you are, two streakers. Just before we go to the corner, have you ever had a 9-letter word come up that there is a word?
No, we haven't. I think that's the closest we've had to an 8-letter, yeah. But we had an audience full of streakers as well while the clock was going round, didn't we? Oh, yes.
Right. What have we got in the corner for this? You've got streaker, obviously.
We have streakers, but the nearest other word is 1 point down at 7. That's retakes.
Retakes. 73 for Gayle, 77 for Grant, and Gayle is going to be putting the letters up there this time.
A consonant, please.
M.
And another.
S.
And another, please.
Another one. N.
And a vowel, please.
O.
Again.
U.
And a third.
And O.
And a consonant.
R.
And another.
T.
And a vowel, please.
And A.
And here's the clock.
Thank you.
this time, Gayle, what do you have?
Just a six.
Just a six, Grant?
Seven.
Seven. Right, let's hear the six.
Motors.
And what about you, Grant?
Amounts.
Amounts, oh, that's correct. Okie doke. What about the corner? What do you have over there?
We have something we thought we'd made up, but it's actually yeah. there. It's called moon rat.
Yep.
It's a sort of...
Insectivorous animal, the hedgehog family.
Of the hedgehog, yes, yeah. That's the one.
That's the one.
Do we any idea what it looks like?
No, because we thought we made it up.
It's got a long snout and a rat-like appearance, yeah. Native to Southeast Asia and China.
Oh, we're not going to see any of them in our gardens, though.
Not, I don't think, too often.
Okay, no. Let's have a look at the scores. 73 for Gayle, 84 for Grant. It's numbers time, and it's nitty-gritty time as well, for all concerned. So will you put some up there, Grant, please?
One large and five small, please.
And five small. OK. It's a crucial numbers game. Never mind a conundrum. Here we go. 7, 4, 3, 10, 6, 50. With a target, all in the 600s today. 671.
671 o'clock. Six, seven, one, Grant?
671.
We've got that, Gayle?
671, but I've not written it down.
Well, you better go first.
10 plus 3 is 13.
10 plus the 3 gives you 13.
Times 50.
Is 650.
And I think I've made a mistake there.
Have you used the 3 twice?
Yeah, I have.
Have you said 3 times 7 is 21?
Yeah. Right, Grant, let's have your version.
10 plus 3 times the 50 is 650.
650.
7 times 4 is 28.
7 multiplied by the 4 gives you 28. I think you've got it.
And I've taken the 6 away and said 21.
No, that's not right either. So they both got it wrong.
Right, Gayle, do you think you can get that one?
Yeah, 50 minus 3 is 47. 10 plus the 4 is 14. If you multiply those two together, you get 658. And then what have I done? 7 plus 6 is 13, and added that on. And that is 671.
671. Strange numbers round that time. I'm afraid it just puts the game out of Gayle's reach now. It's 73 for her, 84 for Grant, but we're coming to the conundrum. And I know Gayle would like to get that. Just make it that 1 point difference. Be a bit galling, but it'll help a little. Right, fingers on the buzzers as we reveal today's countdown conundrum. Grant.
Discharge.
Discharge. Let's have a look. That's what it is, discharge.
Well done, Murphy. Murphy.
73 to Gayle, 94 to Grant. That obviously gives you the game there. And sadly, Gayle, I'm surprised, Gayle, because you were flying and suddenly, mind you, he was playing very well, wasn't he?
I just lost it. I don't know what I've done, but I've just. Yeah. No, he played very well.
I tell you what, it's been lovely talking to you. You'll get all the goodies here. You get the goodie bag. And I'd like to read sometime about you doing some more of your wild and devilish things. You know? I don't know what you've got. Yeah. By the way, on the subject of being scary, because courage takes different forms, would you ever do what that young lady did and jump out of an aeroplane for 10,000 feet?
I've done it.
You haven't. What was that? How? What happened?
Well, I was strapped to somebody else, so it's his responsibility. So.
Who landed on who?
Fortunately for him, it was the other way up.
And would you ever do any bungee jumping, anything daft like that?
No, I think I'm past it.
Yeah, yeah. We're with you on Monday for another countdown. Do be with us. See you then. Bye. Yeah.